Mega Powers partner, Hulk Hogan.
Yeah, the Macho Man Randy Savage. Dig it.
He was one of a kind. He was intense. He was a great athlete. Everything about him was 100% perfect for sports entertainment and professional wrestling.
While the split of the Mega Powers was made official on a February 1989 edition of the Main Event, the cracks had been obvious to many long before that fateful night. Hogan and Savage's friendship had been beneficial to both, which was never more evident than the year prior at WrestleMania 4. On this evening, the vacant WWE Championship was to be decided in a 16-man, one-night tournament. In an absolutely brilliant display of athleticism and heart, the Macho Man would compete in four different matches to claim the championship. But it was in the final against the Million Dollar Man Ted DiBiase that Savage would run into seemingly more trouble than he could handle. In DiBiase's corner was Andre the Giant. Throughout the match, Andre interjected, bringing Savage's offense to a halt, or distracting him for attacks by DiBiase. Eventually, Miss Elizabeth would run into the back, bringing Hogan out to restore some order. And Hogan's presence led to Savage's win with a perfectly timed chair shot that the ref didn't catch. Like I said before, those are the breaks. The Mega Powers would be locked in a heated rivalry with Andre and DiBiase, now known as the Mega Bucks, that culminated with their victory at the very first SummerSlam. Around this time, though, it appeared Randy Savage was jealous of the closeness between Hogan and Elizabeth. Some on commentary would mention it, but many were quick to dismiss that there was any tension between the two. Things got worse at the 1989 Royal Rumble when Hogan eliminated Savage, some claim accidentally, which infuriated the Macho Man. Everything came to a head at the Main Event 2 on February 3rd, 1989. The Mega Powers would compete in tag team action, looking to show the bond was still strong. After Miss Elizabeth was caught up in the action, Hogan would take her to the back for medical attention, leaving the Macho Man alone. Upon his match, altercation in the locker room would make it official. The Mega Powers were dead, and a clash was inevitable. Soon after, Hogan would lay down the challenge for WrestleMania 5. In a final twist, Miss Elizabeth would side with neither man, insisting that she'd be ringside in a neutral corner instead, offering to help either if they needed it. We were able to sit down with Hulk Hogan to talk about the night the Mega Powers explode.
The lines were so blurry between reality and what we were trying to accomplish. He was madly in love with his wife, Elizabeth, for real. He was madly jealous for real. Leading up to it, you know, when she was managing him or managing me or couldn't depend on who she was going to manage, it made him crazy. I just didn't know what type of abuse I was in for, so it was a little nuts. He was there to go, and he pushed the gas pedal down really hard on me in that match. Once you became a Macho Man fan, that was the only thing you could think about. His look, just the way he carried himself, I had nothing but respect for him.
It's always so great to hear from the legends themselves when it comes to these unforgettable WrestleMania moments and matches. Thanks again to Hulk Hogan for his time. Now, let's get you into the middle of an intensely heated WWE Championship match where the world would watch the Mega Powers explode.
Now we're talking!
Hogan came into this match incensed and slowed things down, looking to restore some order. The Macho Man's actions sent a clear message that anything goes and anyone would be fair game. Offense is extinguished as quickly as it started, and Randy Savage seemed to have Hogan on the brink of exhaustion in their mega power collision.
Yeah. Yeah.